Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Since the release of Llama 3.2, the open source LLM community has experienced a significant revolution, especially in vision models and edge computing. We will explore the standout features of Llama 3.2, focusing on its new vision capabilities and provide practical examples for you developers trying to incorporate these models into your project, from simple image classification apps to complex multimodal agent programs. So later I will show you the code to use the Llama 3.2 vision model to create image extraction apps that recognize the context with structured outputs and how these outputs benefit the multi-agent systems by adding this capability. Before that, let's quickly go through the key features of this model. So actually, in the family of Llama 3.2 models, there are two sets of models. One is the smaller and medium-sized vision LLM, which is 11B model and 90B model, enabling image-based understanding and reasoning. And another set is the lightweight text-only models, which is 1B and 3B models, that designed for efficient operations on edge and mobile devices. For the smaller models, it supports context length of 122K tokens, which is quite long for this size of the models, enhancing capabilities for on-device tasks. And also they provide the ecosystem that work with the partners, ensuring wide accessibility and integration options for Llama 3.2. And Meta also provides Llama Stack, which simplifies the deployment across various environments from single node to the cloud and on-device applications. But the key topic in this video is about the 11B and 90B vision models, which is so exciting. So let's see what tasks they can handle. Vision models can handle document level understanding, which interpreting complex documents, including charts and graphs, and also image captioning that generates descriptive captions for images. And also the visual grounding tasks, which is designed to locate objects in images based on the textural descriptions. For the evaluations compared to the two models counterparts, Cloud 3 Haiku and GPT-4o Mini, the 90B model benchmark result shows that it is very competitive in image recognition and a range of visual understanding tasks. If you're curious about how the Llama 3.2 vision model performs but don't want or can't afford a high-end GPU to run it by downloading the weights from Hugging Face, you can use Meta AI's partner, Fireworks AI, a platform that's providing inference API to various language models, including all Llama 3.2 models. The Fireworks AI offers a cost-effective serverless to access the models through a unified API or OpenAI-compatible API to satisfy the needs of LLM app agent developers. If we look at the cost, the Llama 3.2 90B model will cost only $0.9 per million tokens, and one image will normally cost 6,400 text tokens, which means approximately $0.0058 per image input. By signing up for an API key, you can make requests to the Firefox AI endpoint and specify the desired model. Another critical tool for implementing our demo apps is the instructor library. This Python library designed to work with language models to generate reliable, structured outputs by leveraging PyDentic for data validation and schema definition. instructor ensures that the model's responses conform to a specific structure, which will simplify the extraction and utilization of information from model responses. In this API design, instructors smartly provide a wrapper layer for popular models like OpenAI, Claude, and Gemini, and also the model proxies like LightLLM. Such designs will greatly decrease the learning effort for those who are familiar with existing inference APIs. We will see this in details in the code world. Okay, now let's dive into code examples to see how Llama 3.2's vision capabilities can be applied. The first example will be the analyzing a movie screenshot. This application will demonstrate the process of generating basic information from a movie poster or screenshot. First, install the Python packages. Here we should install the OpenAI instructor and Pydantic for this application. The OpenAI packages will actually work for the compatibility of Fireworks API to satisfy the construction requirements of instructor. For the code, let's import these libraries, then define a Pydantic model for the expected output. Here we define three text items for a movie: name, rate, and review, followed by the descriptions. And then we should initialize the instructor client using Fireworks API endpoint here with the Fireworks API key. The endpoint here is compatible with OpenAI API, so we can directly call the constructor method from OpenAI with the redirection of OpenAI. Then we can create a chat completion request with the Llama 3.2 90B model and set the response model with movie rate class we defined before for the output structure. And for the message format, it allows you to upload an image with a text prompt. The image could be as simple as a URL by setting the type of image URL or a base64 encoded local image to replace the internet URL of this. Here I attached a screenshot of the movie Toy Story, and let's see the running result. And here the result is very simple, but including the movie name, Toy Story, movie rate, 5 stars, and movie review, very simple one, an exciting movie with great adventure, suitable for all ages. So that's exactly the structure that we expect for the output. The next fun example is to use a model to generate a cooking recipe from a dish image. So first, as usual, we should import these libraries, and this time we should also include the list from typing, which will be used to define the list type in the Pydantic model. Then define the class, the cooking book, which including the recipe name, ingredients, and instructions. And here you can see the ingredients use a list, which can be a list of ingredients of this recipe. Also the same, initialize the instructor client with the Fireworks endpoint. Now let's create the chat completion request. And give the text prompt as this is a picture of famous cuisine. Please figure out the recipe name and ingredients and write the recipe instructions. And then add the image URL, which is an internet picture of the French cuisine ratatouille. Let's see whether the model can generate the structured recipe of this picture. Okay, let's run it. Okay, the result is generated. The recipe name is ratatouille. Ingredients including a very complete list. And for the instruction part, there will be the cooking recipe. Okay, for a more complex application, we can integrate Llama 3.2's vision capability into a multi-agent system using AutoJ. So let's see how to create a multimodal agent in the AutoJ framework that can extract and analyze the images. To do that, we will use the custom model construction methods in AutoJ to simulate to register a new model, which is actually the Llama 3.2 from Fireworks AI platform with a wrapper by instructor. In addition, we will create another assistant agent in the group chat to generate blog posts based on the information provided by the multimodal agent, which will demonstrate a complete multi-agent system with text and vision capabilities. Let's see how to implement this in code. Here we should also pipe install PyAutoJ and input the required libraries. Then define a PyDentic model for travel destination information, including the destination name, attractions, transportation, accommodation, restaurant, and description of the given travel destination. Next, create a custom client class, custom Llama 3.2 vision client for AutoJ to interact with Llama 3.2 with the instructor wrapper. So the key operation here is in the create method, is to convert the plain text from the user's initial input to the message format that the Fireworks vision model support, as what we did for the previous examples. Here the process will first identify the URL tag in the user's input to locate the image URL from a content that the user provided, and then generate the output content by using the same instructor wrapper from OpenAI that redirect to the Fireworks AI endpoint, and generate output with the response model travel destination class, and then wrap the final response in a defined list. Now we should set up the agent. We should define a config list that includes the custom model that we defined, and set up the user proxy agent that represent the user input, and also the vision assistant that powered by our vision model. And don't forget to register client class of our model to the model client CLS in the register method, register model client for the vision assistant agent. Since we are going to create the blog post based on the image information, so we will create another blog assistant powered by the Llama 3.2 11B model from the inference API of Fireworks AI. Since there will be a group chat, so we should create a group chat object that includes all the agents that we created above, and also a manager that represents the function of orchestration, which is also powered by the text model. which is the 11B in this case. Everything is ready, so we can prompt the group chat by providing the message to the manager in the initial chat method. Here we tell the group chat that this is a picture of a famous destination. Please figure out the destination name, attractions, transportation, accommodation, food, and description, and then generate a blog post based on the given information. And then we put the URL of this image in the URL tag. This is the picture of Great Wall of China, so we will see how this multi-agent system works. Okay, the group chat was clearly orchestrated. So after the user proxy provide our user message, the first to speak is the vision assistant, who generate a structured output about the Great Wall of China destination, including the attractions, accommodations, restaurants, and the overall description of the Great Wall. And after that, the blog assistant show up and generate the blog post based on this information for an entire destination introduction of the Great Wall. That's it for the code walkthrough. Certainly with Llama 3.2's vision capability, many more use cases of multimodal agents are worth exploring.